Hi guys, it's Barbara. I'm here to do a vlog style video. I have a request for my grandbabies, Madison and Christian, to vlog what I'm doing. I am starting the process of making lasagna for my family for Thanksgiving. So here my daughter has chopped one large onion and I have to make two sauces because my youngest daughter is a vegetarian. So I have to make hers separately and not include any meat products in there for her. So she's getting her own little pan, and then I have to make another pot for everyone else. I make this once a year. Basically, I'm gonna start first. Like I start any meal prep is wash your hands first. Okay, hands are clean. All I'm gonna do right now is chop up some other seasonings for the lasagna. I am going to chop up some fresh cilantro, fresh parsley, and fresh scallions. I'm just gonna chop them all up and put them in these separate bowls so that I can use them to season the sauce. So I'm just going to get to doing that. And yeah. And I'm and I do use two different cutting boards. This one will be used only for meat, and we got this out of our FabFitFun. So I will be pounding and chopping the meat on this cutting board and the veggies on this one. Keeping them separate, preventing cross-contamination. I'm gonna use the whole head because I have to make 5 pounds of lasagna. Ridiculous. I am not a chef. This is just the way I do it. Well, there's a million different ways to do it. And a head of fresh cilantro. Cilantro is an aromatic herb, so you're supposed to cut it, not chop it.
And these are just our food scissors. Smells so good.
Okay. All cleaned up. I have boneless, skinless chicken, and I am going to cut this into strips. I'm going to pound these down and cut them into, I'm going to do the pounding off camera so you guys aren't annoyed with that.
Be right.
Okay, guys, this is what the chicken looks like. Super thin. All I've done, here's the rest of it, is put a little bit of salt and pepper on each side. And that's pretty much all I've done. Just super, super thin coat. And some fresh ground pepper from FabFitFun. It's just fresh ground pepper. Now I am going to, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna cut it and put it in this bowl. The bowl is clean. Let me move this out of the way so you can see. I'm just cutting them into slices so that when I put them in the lasagna, they're not thick. Just cutting them into this size pieces. Okay, I'm back. I have all of the chicken cut up into bite-sized pieces. I have my parsley, cilantro, scallions, and onions. I have some classic olive oil, which I'm going to coat the pan with, and then whatever seasonings you choose. I'm just using fresh ground pepper, regular salt, some chicken bouillon to give it extra flavoring. I have some basil and a little bit of turmeric. Just to give it, with all the cheese and everything, it doesn't have a whole lot of nutritional value. At least it gives it a little bit. My diet's bright. And I'm just going to turn on my pan to medium. Little bit of oil, some minced garlic. These go in prior to the sauce. Tablespoon. I'll probably put like 2 or 3 tablespoons in because it's going to be a lot of sauce. I'm not a 2 tablespoons of this, 2 tablespoons of that type of cook. I've been doing this for so long that I can just eyeball it. And yes, I have no makeup on at all. But you love me the way I am or don't love me at all. I'm just using 3/4 of it, so I have some left for my daughter's vegetarian lasagna. You just basically saute it until the onions are clear, and then you can start putting the rest of the stuff in. I like to season mine before and then adjust once it's got all the canned stuff in it, and then you can get a better grip of how much it needs. This point is when I start cooking the chicken. This is what it looks like so far. And I'll just saute this for a little bit until the chicken gets cooked a little. And then I'll start adding the sauce. You could do this by just adding pure fresh tomatoes, chopping them up, and just letting it stew that way. But I ain't got time for that. Hey, no. I ain't doing that. So, I cheat. And it's okay. pretty much cook them until they're all white, like that. I'm gonna start adding some just Walmart brand crushed tomatoes to, it's starting to get dry, so give it a little liquid to work with. I'm gonna start making my daughter's sauce. She's a vegetarian, so no chicken products or any meat products for her. I even need to use a separate spatula because she's that anal about it. And I do try and wash dishes as I go so there's not a big mess to clean for my daughter. So. Just the onions and the scallions. This is just going to be spinach lasagna. Because she doesn't want anything else in it. So, spinach and tomato. I've never made this big of a pan, ever. This is usually the size that I make. Not that one. And then I go in with petite diced tomatoes. This is what it looks like at this point. And where's the other one? That's what the other one looks like. Now I'm putting sauce, tomato sauce, in. this is at the same point. The onions are clear and the garlic and the scallions are all pretty much clear. That's when you can start adding the other stuff to it. I start with crushed tomatoes. She likes spice, so I put more pepper in hers. And I'm gonna put a little Tabasco too. She likes spicy stuff, I don't. This is just basil, dry basil. A little bit of turmeric. It's good for you. And I'm going to put a tiny bit of sage in too. Tomato puree to thicken up the sauce. Diced amber. cilantro and parsley. Sauce for Amber. More diced tomatoes. And paste. When you add paste to the sauce, it'll make it nice and thick so that when you add it to the lasagna later on, it will help make it stick together. Tiny little one for Amber, because she's having a much smaller. This is what this one looks like. And now I'll put this on a medium to low heat and let it simmer for several hours. And this is what the other one looks like. Same thing, I put a cover on them and let them simmer for a few hours and then come back later and check them and taste test them and see what else they need. So I'll be back. Second for you, several hours for me. Hello, everybody. This is the next day, and I am now starting to make the noodles for the sauce. This is what the sauce ended up looking like. This is a chicken non-vegetarian one, and this is the vegetarian, and I will add spinach into this as I put it into the lasagna so that it doesn't end up mushy. And now I am just boiling some water excuse the stains at the bottom of the pan. And I will put the lasagna noodles in there once they're boiled. I did put oil in there and a little bit of salt. And I will cook the noodles in here for 5-6 minutes just so that they're pliable and I can use it to actually make the lasagna. And I will be back then. Check you out in a minute. Okay, we are ready. We have our pot boiling hot water with oil to prevent the noodles from sticking. And then I am just going to put, I'm using Walmart brand lasagna. I'm gonna cook them in the boiling water for 6 minutes and then start my lasagna. I just wanna put them in a little at a time so that they don't. Biggest thing with lasagna is making sure the noodles don't come apart and the edges stay together, and so that you can actually use the noodles. It's like my biggest pet peeve. And I prefer the regular lasagna, not the oven baked. For some reason, that just doesn't work for me. My hands are clean. I'm gonna start with 2 pounds and actually maybe 2.5. A bit more. I can put more in that pan. So we have our 6 minute timer and I will be back in a minute. Okay, the noodles are done. So I'm gonna stick them in the sink. I'm just gonna strain them. You don't need to see that. Actually, I do need to grab some mitts. And I turn on the cold water so that it doesn't affect the seal of my garbage disposal. And I just put them in a cold bath. Where did I put those? Did I put them away? Yeah, I did. I just put them in a bowl of cold water so that when I'm ready to use them, they don't stick together. Thank you. see what I'm doing. I'm just laying them out separately so they don't stick together. And you see they're not quite cooked, but they're very flexible. Perfect for setting up the lasagna. I'm not a chef by any means. I'm not a professional, but I have been making lasagna like this for 30 years and never had a complaint. Everybody loves it, so I must be doing something okay. I'm just going to keep doing this. You guys got the idea. Boring watching. Okay. What I'm doing now is just taking this water, because the noodles are boiling, the water ends up warm. So all I do is just dump it out and put more cold water in it. So it's, the water stays cold instead of being warm. It just makes it easier to work with. Make sure the noodles don't stick. So it'll be enough for now. Okay, now we start making the noodles. Making the lasagna. Hold on. Be right back. Okay, on to the next step. Now we are going to make the ricotta. This is whole milk, but I prefer the skim. But I couldn't find it. Come on. This ricotta is the paste that kind of holds the lasagna together. I add one egg. I That's what she looks like. And that should be enough for one. I do have the other one, but I'm gonna put it back. So now I have to wake my daughter up and get her to shred some cheese. I'll be back.
Hi, we're gonna start making it now. So this is my pan, this is my sauce. This is the ricotta. This is a blend of cheese. This is Parmesan. This is cheddar. And this is mozzarella. You can use whatever cheese you want. It does not matter. Those are my choices. Here we go. And here's the noodles. Can't fit everything in the screen, so you just have to use your imagination. First step. Whoa, I made a mess. Put the bottom of the pan. Anything you girls say will be online. Just an FYI.
Oh my God, that big booty person.
That means you're going to be on the internet.
My voice can be on the internet because I don't know if to be heard in freaking Australia.
I'm deaf. I didn't hear you. You want to make sure that you overlap them, especially on the bottom row. So to give them a good inch, because that's what's going to support the whole thing. Just. Cutting off the excess. Here you go. That's the first layer. Okay, first row. And then I do first row sauce, second row cheese, and I just alternate the cheeses, so. Now you start from the opposite end. So the full strips go down here now. This is it. That's all you do, and I'll come back when it's done. And then the next layer will be sauce and cheese and so on. Okay, we're on the last layer. You continue to crisscross it like this is crisscrossed this way. So now the last layer, I will start this end over here. So it helps hold it together. can use any cheese you prefer. Doesn't have to be the ones that I'm using. You can make it as cheesy or not cheesy, it's up to you. Add a noodles. So I'm just going to use my scraps, or maybe I'll boil some more. Yeah, I'll boil some more. In this, I'll just put a little bit of cheese on top, a little bit of sauce, and that's about it. Just very lightly for presentation. I'll be back once I boil some more noodles. Okay, we're done. This is what she looks like. I'm gonna stick her in the oven for 1 hour at 350. I'm gonna cover it for 30 minutes with aluminum foil so it doesn't burn. Then remove it the last 30 minutes and let it cook. And I will post a picture of what it looks like when it's done. And now I'm gonna go ahead and make my daughter's. I just put her spinach in the pan. I will cook it for 5 minutes and then I will do the same thing with hers. Bye guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Okay, I just thought I'd show you what my daughter's sauce looks like. And that's what she looks like. Beautiful, thick, gorgeous, smells amazing. And yeah, that's gonna go in the oven for an hour. And I'll show you what hers looks like when I'm done. Okay, I'm done. This is what my daughter's looks like, completely finished. I'm gonna stick them in the oven, edit the video, and try and get it up. I will take a picture of both of them when they're done. Hope you enjoyed the video. Have a wonderful Thanksgiving, and happy holidays to all of you. Bye.